we have sought a decisive mandate from the people of Karnataka in this election, and going by the trends, it appears that people have given us a decisive mandate in BJP's favor. So first of all, the credit should go to the people of Karnataka. Then, of course, Honorable Prime Minister has worked so very hard, and he is always a very popular leader, and his hard work has paid off. About Amit Shah, everybody knows he is a master craftsman when it comes to election strategy. He has put in place an excellent election strategy, and he has burnt a lot of midnight oil there. He spent lots of weeks in Karnataka. That also has paid off. I also would like to give credit to Karnataka's leadership and cadres, right from Yediyurappa down to party cadres, especially to the Parivar. The Sangh Parivar cadres have also helped us enormously. When I analyze certain regions, we realize that in coastal Karnataka, we are completely swept of the region. That would not have been possible without the support of the Parivar also. And take the case of the region of Hyderabad, Karnataka. Telugu Desham Party in Andhra Pradesh and the Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu have used all ethical and unethical means to influence Telugu voters to vote against BJP. But look at the end result. Out of the 40 seats in that region, I was personally taking care of that region also. Out of 40, BJP has won more than 20 seats. Whereas in the last election, we could only secure 6 seats. It shows that the cadres also worked very hard, and the people of Hyderabad, Karnataka region, the Telugu people, have rejected Telugu Desham Party's tactics, Chandrababu's misleading campaigns, and I would say BJP Southward march has begun.